Hello, in this video, we are going to talk about communication channels which are used in computer networks. Now we know a computer network is a group of computers linked to each other that enables a computer to communicate with each other and share their resources, data, and applications. Now these computers are linked to each other with different types of communication channels. These communication channels are also known as communication media or transmission media, and it is a path that connects the sender and receiver for transmission of information over a network. At a broad level, the communication channels are divided into two types, guided media and unguided media. Guided media is also known as wired or bounded media, because the data signals are enclosed in a cabling media. In guided media, the communication devices are directly connected with each other via wires or physical media for data transmission. Examples are twisted pair cables, coaxial cables, and fiber optics. Unguided media is also known as wireless media. It can also be used at each and every place where it is impossible to install cables. Here, electromagnetic waves of different frequencies are used. Some examples of unguided media are microwave, broadcast radio, cellular radio, infrared, and communication satellites. Let's take a look at various guided media in detail. First is twisted pair wire. It has data transmission speed between 10 Mbps to 10 Gbps. It is most popular and is used as communication media in LAN and local telephone lines. It can carry voice and data signals. Signals are transmitted using copper pair wires which are insulated by plastic that have been physically twisted together. The wires are twisted together in order to reduce noise. The electrical disturbance that can degrade the communication is called noise. It is of two types, unshielded twisted pair, which is UTP, and shielded twisted pair, which is STP. Twisted pair is comparatively inexpensive and easy to install and maintain. Its disadvantage is that it is unsuitable for long distance. Its speed is less than coaxial cable or fiber optics. Next is coaxial cable, and it is also termed as coax. The data transmission speed is around 10 to 100 Mbps. It is used for video transmissions for televisions or for long distance telephone lines and LANs for voice and data transmission with very high frequency. It is made up of a single solid copper wire core that is covered by insulating material. A copper mesh is used to cover the insulated copper wire. It also protects the cable from noise such as electromagnetic waves. It can carry both analog and digital signals. It carries high frequency range signals with bandwidth 80 times higher than the twisted pair wire. It is of two types, thick net and thin net. The disadvantages of coaxial cable is that it is more expensive than twisted pair and it is not compatible with twisted pair either. Next is fiber optics. Here, data transmission speed is more than 100 Gbps. It is used for internet or long-distance communication. Here, digital signals are sent as light pulses which are translated back into electrical signals. It has a fine glass strand as core surrounded by glass cladding and a protective layer. The glass cladding reflects light back into the core, guiding the light along the wire. Thousands of transmissions can be carried out on a single strand. It is secure and has a very low signal loss. The disadvantage of fiber optics is that it is very expensive and also difficult to install and modify. It is difficult to repair and one fault can bring down the entire network. Unguided media is also known as wireless media. It can also be used at each and every place where it is impossible to install cables. Here, electromagnetic waves of different frequencies are used. Some examples of unguided media are microwave, broadcast radio, cellular radio, infrared, and communication satellites. Let's take a look at each of them. First is microwave. Here, the data transmission speed is between 1 Mbps to 10 Gbps. It is used for high-speed transmissions. Information is sent via microwave from ground-based transmitting and receiving stations. Text, sound, and graphics are converted into microwave pulses and transmitted. Microwave stations, that is, repeater stations, must be placed every 50 kilometers to receive, amplify, and then pass the signal along. Its disadvantages are that it cannot pass through obstacles and can only use line-of-sight transmission. That's why the stations are installed on tall towers and buildings. It also supports very limited bandwidth. Next is broadcast radio. The data transmission speed is between 1 Mbps and 10 Mbps. It is used for cordless phones, AM and FM radio transmission for both voice and data. It can travel over long distances and penetrates building easily. Radio transmission requires a transmitter to broadcast radio signals and a receiver to receive it. The receiver uses an antenna to receive the signals. An example of the short-range broadcast radio communication is Bluetooth, which is used in computers, mobiles, printers, etc. It uses short-range radio waves to transmit data at a rate of 1 Mbps among Bluetooth-enabled devices. The disadvantage of radio is that it is unidirectional and insecure means of communication. It also has multipath interference, such as reflection from water and land bodies. Next is cellular radio. With 4G, the data transmission speed is between 10 Mbps to 1 Gbps. It is specifically used in wireless modems and cellular telephones. The cellular telephone is also a telephone device that uses high-frequency radio waves to transmit voice and digital data. However, some mobile users connect notebooks or mobile computers also to cellular telephone to access the web or send and receive the email, etc. Personal Communication Services, or PCS, is a set of technologies used for digital cellular devices like laptops, cellular telephones, etc. Its disadvantage is that it requires complex infrastructure and a well-planned frequency spectrum distribution beforehand. Next is satellite communication. Here, the data transmission speed is between 1 Mbps to 10 Gbps. It is used for global mobile communication. Satellites are placed in space and they orbit the Earth. It receives microwave signals from the Earth station. Communication satellites magnify the signal and retransmit them back to Earth. The data transfer speed of the communication satellite is very high and it avoids the cost of cabling and repeater stations. The transmission from the Earth station to a satellite is called uplink, and the transmission from the satellite to the Earth station is called the downlink. The disadvantage of it is that it is very expensive and not easy to repair and maintain. Weather and sunspots can also cause signal disturbance. Next is infrared wireless transmission media. It has transmission speed up to 1 Gbps. It is used in remote controls for television, optical mouse, and most other entertainment devices. It sends signals using infrared light wave that is invisible to us and is just above the red end of the color spectrum. It works over a moderate bandwidth of 115 kbps and works up to 10 meters. IRDA port is normally fixed in mouse, printer, and any digital device in order to enable them to transfer data from one device to another using infrared light waves. It is also an alternative to short-range communication devices like Bluetooth. Its disadvantage is that it has short range and low bandwidth. It also requires a line of sight transmission. Here is a summary of all different mediums in one frame for you to revise before the exam. If you liked our video, do press like and also subscribe to our channel. Thank you and goodbye.